everyone, and welcome to Ken Sundstrom Field at the Cardinal Sports Complex for CTN's live coverage of high school baseball. It's a Northwest Suburban Conference showdown between two 5-8 teams as the Coon Rapids Cardinals host the Champlin Park Rebels. Joe Young, Howie Shapiro behind home plate. And Howie, it is sunny, it is warm, threatening to hit 90 for the first time this season. This after a tornado struck parts of Coon Rapids just last night.
Yeah, it's quite a contrast in yesterday versus today, but it is nice. We're sitting out, we're working on our tans. Beautiful, beautiful baseball weather, and we're looking forward to a pretty good contest between a couple of even teams, both coming in at 5-8.
Champlin Park coming in off a 2-1 win over Anoka, a team that Coon Rapids dropped a 10-run affair to just last week. Jack Harris will lead things off for the Rebels, followed by Justin Brooks. Andrew Rackow, the first baseman, will hit in the number three spot. Ryan Oberstar, the DH, in the cleanup spot. Christian Backriches, the left fielder, will hit fifth, followed by Toby Bovers, Zach Zahalka, Tyler Trombley, and finally Joe Thorldson.
You know, both these teams right one after each other towards the bottom of the standing in the conference. Champlin Park, we said both 5-8. Champlin Park's 3-6 in the conference, whereas the Cardinals are 2-6.
Coon Rapids has seen a pretty fluid lineup throughout this season. Adam Powell, Colin McCullough, and Mason Myrie getting the start in the outfield grass. Left to right this afternoon, Patrick Wright at first, Zach Novak at second, Mark Manders manning the shortstop position with Zach White at third, and Jaden Kopp behind the plate calling the pitches for starter Tommy Dutton, who gets a strike across to start the ball game. Second pitch hit well toward the right center gap. It is going to fall, and it's extra bases for Jack Harris. Right off the bat, just the second pitch of the ball game, and it's in for a stand-up double.
Harris did a nice job of turning on that pitch and drilling it to the deeper part of right center field, and a nice way for the Rebels to start this ball game. Leadoff double for Jack Harris as he got a hold of that pitch. That was up a little bit in the zone, and he was able to drive it. Tommy Dutton comes in with a 1-0 record, Joe, in 21 innings pitched, 21 strikeouts, 15 hits, 7 runs, 4 of those earned, a 1.33 earned run average.
That'll bring up Justin Brooks, the second baseman, with one out, or with no out, and a runner at second base. Swings through a high fastball and falls behind in the count, 0-1. Shows bunt, takes a pitch up over the brim of his helmet, and it evens the count 1-1.
Yeah, he's trying to come with that fastball, but just a little bit too high on that pitch.
Shows bunt again, and got it off the top of the bat, fouls it off the backstop. 1-2, that'll take the sacrifice out of play.
Good time for a K here for Dutton. He's got some pitches to waste a little bit, see if he can get him to look at chasing something.
Curveball was hanging there, and he hammers it to deep left field. It is over the head of Powell. He's able to track it down quickly and get it back in. Fortunately, Harris had to wait to make sure it hit the ground, so he is not able to score, but back-to-back doubles to start the inning for the Rebels. They have two in scoring position with nobody out here in the first.
Yeah, great opportunity here for Champlin Park with nobody out and two runners on. And again, hitting Dutton hard here early on, first two batters of the lineup. We are going to have a
curveball fouled away by Rackow. 0-1.
If I'm seeing that correctly, Bovers came in to run.
No. Fastball in, 1-1, or 0-2. I don't think so. I think that's still Rakow, or Brooks out there, number 9.
I thought it was number 8. But.
Pitch up high. It would be awfully odd because Bovers is scheduled to be the sixth hitter. I think you saw him come over to give his guard, his arm guard to the first base coach. Curveball again, just hanging there, and Rakow fouls it out of play. That curveball in the dirt. Good stop by Kopp. Make sure nobody can go anywhere. Count goes to 2-2.
Yeah, he just had to slide to his right and get his body in front of the pitch. So that was hit the dirt.
Fastball didn't miss by much. Kopp held and waited, hoping that he could frame it up for strike three. Instead, it is ball three and a full count to Andrew Rakow. With two runners in scoring position, nobody out here in the top of the first inning. This one hit high to left field. Going back is Powell, chasing to his left. It's going to get over his head as well. Both runners are going to come in to score. We've got three straight doubles to open the ball game for the Champlin Park Rebels.
Yeah, and again, wind is blowing from right to left, and that ball just took off, I think, at the end a little bit. Powell wasn't sure exactly where it was, but it's going to fall behind him up to the fence, and easily two runs coming across, and exactly the way the Rebels wanted to start. They have three hits, two runs with nobody out here at the top of the first, and another runner in scoring position in Rakow.
That'll bring up the designated hitter, Ryan Oberstar. Infield in on the left side, and that curveball floats in for strike one. This one chopped left side. White looks at the runner, he's going to throw that way. It's over the head of Novak and out into center field, and that will be an error. Everybody's safe. Still nobody out.
Well, the Rebels continue to do a good job of putting runners on base. A good throw low may have had him.
Well, once you got him turned around, I think Zach had time to get it over to first base. You got to have the out. This one slashed right at first base. Right catches it on a line for out number one.
Well, the Cardinals needed that.
Bover's first pitch chopped up the middle, and no chance anywhere as Dutton comes off the field or off the mound to field it. Base is loaded, one away, two already across here in the top of the first inning. Got three doubles and then infield single on the bunt.
It was a good play. I like the thought of it. And again, this Dutton can't pick the ball up cleanly.
Curveball gets a swinging strike from Zahalka.
Well, the Rebels looking to open up a big inning here if they can get a base hit in this situation with bases loaded.
This one hammered to right center over the head of Myrie, who came in to try and field it. No one moved too far because they thought he was going to catch it. Instead, it's an RBI single for Zahalka.
Yeah, Matt Mossy's going to take a walk out to the mound here early. Not something that he had planned for, as that ball is going to get away from Myrie.
definitely not the start the Cardinals were hoping for.
No, already five base hits.
Just in six batters.
Yeah, bases loaded and what, just one away.
Seven batters, sorry. Yeah. Five base hits and one reached on error.
Yep.
Well, they've taken the error off the board for the Cardinals. I don't know how that works. Because that was definitely an error on...
Oh, absolutely.
On Zach White. It's questionable whether it was an error on the sacrifice bunt attempt. Curveball hit right back through the middle. Manders dives but cannot come up with it. Everybody moves 90 feet. RBI single for Trombley. Throw gets away from Kopp. And everybody's going to get another on the second error of the inning for the Cardinals.
So a couple more runs come across, and now they've opened their lead to 4-0 with just one away. As you mentioned, two runners in scoring position. Manders tried to make that effort, diving out for that ball, but it just got underneath him. And of course, that throw into the plate got away from Kopp, allowing that other runner to score to make it 4-0.
5-0.
5-0, I'm sorry.
So they've hit the order here in the first and still only one out, two in scoring position for Joe Thoroldson. First pitch skied right side behind the infield. Novak backs up, makes the catch just into the outfield grass for out number two.
And an all-important second out for Coon Rapids as they need to stop the bleeding here and get out of the inning.
So back to the top of the order, Jack Harris started the whole thing with a double to right center. Curveball misses low, 1-0. Another curveball low, 2-0.
Yeah, again, trying not to give him something that he can hit. And trying to stay that low portion of the plate. Wants to try and catch something low. Maybe force a ground ball.
There he gets a strike. 2-1. Up high, skips away from Kopp, but not far enough for anyone to try and advance. It'll be 3-1. And that is ball four, first walk of the ball game, and the bases are loaded once more with two away.
And again, some dangerous hitting at the top of the lineup. That time he worked the walk, did Harris, but that brings up Brooks, who hit a double his last time up.
A long first inning of work here for Tommy Dutton. And now struggling to find the zone. It had not been a problem through the first nine batters he faced. Unfortunately, they were barreling it up. Fastball chopped, will be foul in front of third base.
Well, and Dutton just has to be confident that he can get Brooks here at the plate. Hit him.
And he hit him. Hit batter with bases loaded will bring in the sixth run of the first inning. So Andrew Rakow, who had a two-run double earlier in this inning, that started the scoring. Now batting the first baseman, number 23, Two out, bases still loaded. Fastball fouled back out of play. Rocco was up there for a while, fouled off a two-strike pitch, got to a full count, and then drove one over the head of Adam Powell and left.
Yeah, he gave that ball a ride.
This pitch misses low, evens the count 1-1. Curveball down and away.
As you mentioned, just trouble in locating pitches.
Fastball hit high to center field. Coming in on it is McCullough. He'll make the catch, and the inning finally comes to an end. But six runs on six hits, a couple of Cardinal errors. Cardinals in a big hole. They look to respond when we return in the bottom half after this on CTN. There you see the flag out in center field, consistently blowing right to left, and that factored into a couple of those long fly balls to left field. Cardinals have their work cut out for them. Mark Manders, the shortstop, will hopefully take the first step towards getting them back. He'll be followed by the DH, Tyler Donnell. Zach White hitting third. Jaden Kopp in the cleanup spot. Zach Novak, then Patrick White, Tommy Dutton, Mason Myrie, and Adam Powell round out the order for head coach Matt Mossy.
Manders has continued his hot hitting this season, hitting .378, Joe, as he steps to the plate.
Off-speed pitch outside, 1-0. And Jack Lovin towing the rubber in a great spot. You always got to like it when you, the first time you get out there, you have a 6-1 lead.
Absolutely.
Fastball on the outside edge evens it up, 1-1. Another fastball called for a strike at the letters. Gets Lovin ahead in the count, 1-2.
Oh, rung him up.
Called third strike, looked a little wide. Manders certainly felt it was outside, but painted the edge. And just the start Lovin wanted on the mound as well. His defense behind him. Backridges, Bovers, and Zahalka in the outfield. We'll see if we can get the Champlin Park defense up next. Donnell falls off the first offering.
Donnell hitting .243 on the season. And, you know, there are a number of Cardinal hitters that would like to see their averages get south, at least south of 200.
North of 200?
I mean, north of 200. Sorry, did I say south? I meant north. There we go.
There they go. Backridges, Bovers, and Zahalka in the outfield. Andrew Rockow at first. Justin Brooks at second. Tharaldson is the shortstop. Harris at third. Tyler Trombley is behind the plate. Lovin gets Donnell swinging and gets ahead in the count 0-2. Drops another breaking pitch in for another called third strike. Back-to-back punch outs to start the outing for Jack Lovin.
Yeah, you couldn't ask for much better than that. Your first two batters, you ring up, and now opportunity for Zach White to see what he can do about extending this inning.
This one fouled and out of play. Good White. Patience, waiting on the off-speed pitch, just needs to straighten it out.
Hitting 185 as he steps to the plate.
Lovin misses low, 1-1. This one hit well to left. Backing up is Backridge's. He's there for the out. So after a big top half of the first at the plate, a quick inning in the field for the Rebels. They look to add to their 6-run lead after this on CTN.
Hand-washing is one of the best ways to stay healthy all year long.
Beautiful day to be at the ballpark. At least Cardinal fans have that going for them. It has not been a beautiful start to the ball game for the home team.
It definitely has not. They've fallen behind 6-0, 6 hits for the Rebels as well. And, you couldn't ask for a better start to a ball game for them.
Yeah, 6 runs. They left the bases loaded as well. Ryan Oberstar reached on an error. Swings under the high heat. 0-1. Although they later took the error off the board for his hit, so I think they're saying he reached on a fielder's choice. But since this one driven right down the left field line, one hops the fence. Powell got there quickly, but it's another stand-up double for the Rebels. Their 7th hit, 4 of them have been extra bases.
Yeah, they've been hitting the ball hard off of Dutton here early on. That one was no exception. He drilled that one to the left field corner. And you see it bounce up and off the fence. One hopped it. Easy stand-up double for him.
And now Christian Backridge's lined it to first base in his first at bat. In this part of the order, they went quick. Batters 5, 6, 7, 8. Only saw one pitch each. This one rolled to short. Manders Fields throws high. It's off the top of the glove of Wright. That one will be an error. And Oberstar will come in to score make it 7-0.
I didn't think Matt had to hurry his throw there, but Mark had to hurry his throw there. I felt that maybe he thought so. And that's why I think he threw that as high as he did. I think, If he didn't rush it, his throw, he may have had him at first. You can see the ball take off. He had plenty of opportunity to get him.
This one down and in, skips away from Kopp, and Backridge's moves over to second base. And the merry-go-round on the bases continues for
a nice pitch.
The Champlin Park Rebels. There is that curveball falling in at the right time, gets the break in the right spot. Count is 1-1 to Bovers. This one grounded right side. Wright will field it. Pitch to Dutton covering. He gets the out. Backridge's moves over to third on the play.
Well, the Rebels did what they wanted. They moved the lead runner along to third and made it interesting at first just to make sure they got the out with the throw to Dutton off the mound.
Zahalka, an RBI single in the first inning, an opportunity to add another RBI here. He drives the first pitch he sees deep to center field. McCullough is there for the catch, tagging and scoring on the sacrifices. Zahalka, it's an 8-run lead. Or Backridge's, rather. Zahalka hit the sacrifice.
So that'll make it 8-0. We're getting report that Logan Ness is warming up in the bullpen for Coon Rapids.
And that'll bring up Trombley. Takes a pitch on the outside edge for a strike, 0-1. Trombley, an RBI single, first time up. Base is clear with two away. Pitch down and away, 1-1. This one fouled off of Kopp. 1-2. Swung through a high fastball for strike three. Two more, though, on the board for Champlin Park. They lead Coon Rapids 8-0 after an inning and a half. You're watching high school baseball live on CTN.
Owen, when you came into my life, it was a whirlwind.
I just can't do it.
We didn't know what the future would hold, but we knew you would always be a part of it. Adopting you was the best decision in our life. And I'm so proud to call you my son.
Did you know you can raise backyard chickens? But a permit is required, and there's a limit of 4 female chickens per property. No roosters or other fowl are allowed. And there are specific rules for the chicken coop and run. For more information on this and other city codes, log on to coonrapidsmn.gov.
Seven hits, 8 runs through 2 innings. A couple of Cardinal errors have assisted the Rebels in their very fast start. Jaden Kopp, Zach Novak, and Patrick Wright due up here in the second. Jack Lubin made quick work of the Cardinals in the bottom half of the first, hoping to do the same here.
Yeah, again, came out his first inning pitching with a 6-0 lead. Now his teammates tack on an additional 2 to give him an 8-0 cushion. He must be loving that.
Leading off for the catcher, number 23, Jaden Kopp.
Kopp hitting in the cleanup spot. He's had a decent season at the plate.
Yeah, he's hitting 351. I think that's pretty good.
rolls this one to second. Brooks to Rackow, a really easy first out.
Not the way the Cardinals wanted to start this bottom half of the second.
Now batting for the Cardinals, the second baseman, number 14, Zach Novak.
Zach Novak, a sophomore that has cracked his way into the varsity lineup the last couple of weeks.
Well, he's hitting 750. He's been up to the plate just four times. He's had three hits, two of those hits doubles.
And that is how you crack the varsity lineup.
Absolutely.
A speed pitch called for a strike at the letters, and Lovin quickly ahead in the count 0-2. Trying to tempt him with something outside. Novak not biting.
Ooh. That pitch didn't miss by much.
2-2. Because I believe the fifth game that we've televised this season, and still looking for win number one on CTF.
Pretty soon, Matt will stop responding to my texts.
Or he'll respond with just stay away.
Oh, game canceled. Don't bother. It's you again.
Do you have to?
Please, I told you to lose my number.
2-2 pitch, good. Curveball from Lovin got Novak fishing. For out number two, third strikeout of the ball game for Lovin already.
The first baseman, number 28, Patrick Wright.
That'll bring up the first baseman, Patrick Wright.
Wright hitting 185.
This one hits solidly to right. That's going to drop in for at least one. Big turn at first, but Zahulka gets there and gets it back in quickly. Two-out single, first hit of the ball game for the Cardinals.
That's the jump the Cardinals were looking for, try and get that first base hit. Comes with two outs.
Pitcher number 35, Tommy Dutton.
That'll bring up the pitcher, Tommy Dutton, a chance to help his own cause. And boy, would he like to.
He would. I mean, he wants to get his stick going as well. He's hitting 158 as he steps to the plate.
First pitch fouled back out of play. To get some aggression out and some frustration. See if he can barrel one up and put a hurt on the ball. Up high, 1-1. Off-speed pitch in for a strike.
Nice pitch to go ahead in the count.
Well, Lovin trying to work quickly, wants to get his team back to the plate. The bats are hot. And that one just outside, 2-2.
Cardinals would love they can try and chip into this 8-0 lead.
Slap foul, and Dutton will stay alive. Curveball fouled back out of play.
That was close to being yours, Joe.
Maybe
a little bit to your right.
Maybe a few years ago. I don't have those kind of wheels anymore.
No quick like reflexes, cat like reflexes any longer. Ooh.
Breaking pitch, misses low, full count. Yeah, if it's an old arthritic cat, maybe. 3-2 pitch. down low, ball four.
Now Cars have a little something cooking with two away here.
Ryan Tolm out to have a word with his starter, the whole infield coming in.
I just, I don't know if they want to talk about, you know, we've got an 8-0 lead, let's get out of this inning without any runs coming across.
Certainly not a lot of danger at this point. One hit through the first seven he's faced. He's at three strikeouts. That is his first walk. It's the first time he'd been to three balls.
Now batting for the Cardinals, the right fielder, number 38.
Mason Myrie. Right fielder. You see a lot of sophomores in the lineup for this Cardinals squad, a very young team.
Yes, for sure. Myrie hitting 154 as he steps to the plate, but it's great to get all these young kids involved at this level, quite obviously. And you know, if they can push for starting jobs, let them play. And this is great experiences for the next few years.
Called strike on the inside edge, evens it up at 1-1. And the best of that class not playing this season.
Right.
We saw Jared Fearing play the entire season last year as a freshman. And then in the fall, injured his ACL last game of the football season.
Yeah, tough to see. He's a good young man.
Had a really nice football season
this
year as a sophomore.
Plus he rocks the flow, which is always good.
A fair amount of salad there.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Called strike, evens it out. 2-2 with two on, two out. Love it. We'll have to try again as Myrie fouls this one back and out of play.
Yeah, a little bit of a tougher inning for Jack Lovin as he's throwing some more pitches than he did in that first.
Well, he cruised through the first pretty quickly. Just 10 pitches, eight of them for strikes. Had back-to-back punch-outs to start. This one grounded to the right side. Brooks bobbled it. Everybody safe. First error of the ball game for Champlin Park. Bases loaded with two out for Adam Powell.
Brooks just didn't get his glove onto it. Cardinals will take it. Bases loaded, as you mentioned. Jacob Powell's hitting 105 as he steps up plate. Big opportunity for him here with bases loaded. Two away.
Well, and a big hit here could dramatically change this ball game early on. Breaking pitch outside, 2-0.
Well, Lovin's having a little difficult time now finding the zone.
Up high, 3-0.
Yeah, he's in danger now of walking in a run.
Powell taking all the way. It's belt high strike, 3-1. That one's up high, ball four. Second walk of the inning for Lovin. This one with bases loaded. We'll get Coon Rapids on the board as Patrick Wright trots home with the first run of the game for the home squad.
Now batting for the Cardinals, the shortstop number 18.
Back to the top of the order, Mark Manders. Punched out on a pitch that was on the outside edge. He felt was a little outside. Stays patient with a fastball in, 1-0.
Yeah, a big spot for a big hitter here.
Called strike, and that's just about the same pitch that he got rung up on.
Yep.
First time, and all of this coming with two outs. Loving got the first two outs pretty quick, got Jaden Kopp to ground out on the first pitch of the inning. Then a strikeout of Zach Novak. This one fouled back out of play. But then the single by Wright, a walk by Dutton. The error allowed Myrie to reach, and an RBI walk for Adam Powell. Trying to get out of it, a 1-2 pitch on the way to Mark Manders. Called third strike, this time on the inside edge. And Coon Rapids leaves the bases loaded. They trail Champlin Park 8-1 after two innings. You're watching high school baseball live on CTN.
I used to drive an ambulance as an EMT, and I've always tried to be a safe driver. If people knew what I know, lives could be saved. In my car, if I see a truck or bus taking a turn, I know to take my time. When big vehicles turn right, they may swing wide to make the turn. If you try to sneak in, well, it's a lesson you'd rather not learn the hard way. When trucks and buses turn, let's you and I wait. It's our roads, it's our safety.
I'm a first generation Filipino American.
You don't always feel you're a part of the country you live in. It's this weird middle space sometimes that you have to live inside of. But when you meet others that are also living in that space, you'll learn to know that that is its own unique space too.
First, and a big lead as we get ready to start the third. A new pitcher on the hill for the home squad. Logan Ness will take over. Joe Thoroldson, the shortstop, will lead things off.
Logan comes in with a 1-2 record. He's pitched 12 innings, getting up 13 hits, 13 runs, and 11 of those earned. His earned run average is 6.42, 17 strikeouts in 12 innings pitched, but yet 13 base on balls.
Thoroldson, the shortstop, popped up just beyond second base. This one grounded up the middle. Manders fields, throws to right, and there's one down. Making the routine plays look routine. That is what the Cardinals need from here on out.
Absolutely.
Couple of errors in the ball game. Good fastball there to Jack Harris. Starts him with a strike, 0-1. Harris doubled and scored and then walked. Both of those at-bats coming in the first inning. Pitch down and in, evens it up, 1-1.
Well, yeah, the Cards would love a quick inning here. It's, you know, they got one run back in the bottom of the second.
Two and one. This one hit well to right. Myrie ranges to his left, makes the catch for out number two.
The second baseman, number nine, Justin Brooks.
Bring up Justin Brooks. He doubled and scored, and then got an RBI hit by pitch. The again, both in that first inning when the Rebels scored six. Ness misses outside, 1-0. This one hit well between White and Manders on the left side for a two-out single.
Yeah, not much either one of them could do because that ball was hit sharply between them. Rebels seeing if they can get a little opportunity to get that run back that they gave up with two away. Cardinals had a decent inning with two away, just couldn't get the run production they wanted.
Andrew Rocco. Two-run double. And a fly to center field. Both in that first inning as well. Now with two out and one on. Hits this one high and deep to center. But there in plenty of time is Colin McCullough for out number three. A two-out single for the Rebels, but the man left stranded. Cardinals back at the dish when we come back on CTF.
I don't remember how it started.
North of that.
Our back and forth. It always came back.
Dad!
You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
Wash, washy, wash, washy, wash, wash your hands. Scrub them while you sing this song. Wash, washy, wash, washy, wash, wash. Rub your hands and fingers and the places in between. Using soap and water makes your hands so clean. Wash your hands. Great job, you're almost done. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now dry.
Wash your hands for 20 seconds, just like Elmo.
Back at the ballpark. Coon Rapids, a big hole to try and dig out of. As we start the bottom of the third, Tyler Donnell, Zach White, and Jaden Kopp, the scheduled hitters. Donnell, a strikeout. First time he faced Lovin. Lovin retired the first five he faced and then struggled a little bit to get that final out in the second inning. Cardinals were able to scratch a run across with a hit, an error, and a couple of walks.
Well, they're looking to scratch a few more here this inning.
Off-speed pitch, called a strike on the inside edge, 1-1. Swung on and missed, and Lovin ahead in the count.
Yeah, good spot for him here.
Comes back with another fastball, gets to now swinging. Starts the inning with a strikeout, his fifth of the ball game.
Yeah, he didn't get into a little trouble until in that last inning until the Cardinals had a couple of outs.
Zach White. First pitch, grounded to short, scooped up by Tharaldson across for Rockow, and there's two down.
Made that one look easy.
Now Jaden Kopp.
Catcher, number 23, Jaden Kopp.
Ground ball to second base. Pitch in there for a strike, 0-1. And the fastball misses low and evens it up. And that's something, you know, White jumping on that first pitch.
Mm-hmm.
I like to see guys be aggressive, and we talk about it a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, at the same time, you have to be able to work the count and get deep into counts. Off-speed pitch drops in. And again, loving ahead in the count, 1-2.
I was just trying to be comfortable in the box. And
fastball chopped to the left side. Knocked down by Harris. The throw is wide. Kopp will dig and go for second. And he is in there safely. Second error of the game for Champlin Park. And it gets Coon Rapids a runner in scoring position with two away.
Well, that's how they got their run in the second inning, in the bottom of the second, by getting base runners with two away. There you just see that, just can't look that into his glove, and then there's the throw, and it's off the mark.
Bring up Zach Novak. Struck out in his first at bat. An opportunity to drive in another run here for the Cardinals.
Again, there's plenty of time left in this game. They just need to chip away. And the important thing, too, is when the Rebels are at the plate, they have to prevent run production as well. But got to be productive at the plate, especially when you're down by seven.
Well, we saw an early trip to the mound after the first two runners reached in that second inning. And Coon Rapids really able to get to Lovin a little bit once he gets rattled. Now, he had a little more trouble finding the zone, and you know, the error certainly assisted them getting that run. Could assist in helping them add runs here. This one slapped into right field. It'll fall well in front of Zahalka. They're going to send Kopp home. The throw is there, and he is out at the plate. It'll be a single for Novak, but Kopp thrown out at the dish. And it's 8-1 as we go to the fourth on CTF.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
Pooches at the park.
Back at Ken Sundstrom Field. Big inning to start the ball game for Champlin Park. Put up six runs in the top of the first inning, added a couple in the second. And they are cruising 8-1 as we start the fourth.
Man, Logan Ness has took over last inning for Tommy Dutton. He's just trying to keep the Rebel hitters at bay here and not allow any more run production. The Cardinals had an opportunity in the bottom half of the third, but good relay got him at the plate.
Ryan Oberstar, a double and a run scored in the second inning. Reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the first. Originally called an error, but later changed to a fielder's choice. No one fouled well out of play, 1-2. lays off a pitch down low, 2-2. Yeah, and that's a solid inning in the third. Able to get the three outs pretty quickly and just allowed a two-out single. This one hit well to center, but McCullough able to get there for out number one.
Yeah, it got there pretty quickly, and McCullough did a good job of just ranging to his right a little bit, making the catch.
That'll bring up Christian Backridges. Backridges a line out to first in the first. Reached on an error and scored in the second. This one popped up behind short, backing up his Manders, and he's able to stay with it to make the catch.
That was nice.
It was an adventure.
And the key is he looked it into his glove and made sure he closed it. And again, you see and McAuliffe running in from center. But just a nice job over the shoulder catch.
That'll bring up Toby Bovers. Dropped down a solid bunt and reached in the first. Swung on and missed. Grounded out to first in the second. And now Ness way ahead in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, obviously a good position to be in. And Logan's, he's a pretty quick worker, and he's come in and pitched pretty well in relief of Tommy Dutton.
And he gets the three-pitch strikeout, retires the Rebels in order here in the fourth. Still, it's Champlin Park 8, Coon Rapids 1. Bottom half of the fourth inning coming up next on CTF.
As the world faces the challenges of the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, Lions recognize that kindness matters now more than ever. And Lions and Leos are finding ways to continue to serve our communities. For more than 100 years, in times of need, Lions always find a way to help those around them. And after we emerge from this, we will be stronger than ever. Visit lionsclubs.org to learn more.
I was the lead gunner of the convoy that we had. While I was suppressing fire, I felt a flick on my upper bicep area. Right after my recovery, I had to find myself again and see what else I could do to continue my selfless service. Having an organization like the Coalition to Salute America's Heroes, putting me back into working with wounded troops, helped me to process my injury. I'm Sergeant Mary Herrera, and my alive date was November 8th, 2003.
For more information, visit saluteheroes.org.
Champlin Park Rebels blew up in the top of the first inning. First three had doubles. They had six hits, scored six times in that first inning. Coon Rapids able to get one run back in the bottom half of the second. But then the run thrown out at the plate in the bottom half of the third. And they trail 8-1 as we start the bottom of the fourth. Zach Wright, one of only two hits in the game. He scored the only run of the game thus far.
Well, the Cardinals, just what the doctor ordered, a quick inning to get back to the plate.
Wright wanted to swing, but
I thought he was
able
going
to check the swing as that pitch was down and away. They check down, and I agree.
I would have as well.
I would have asked for that as well, but able to check the swing, 1-1. Another pitch in the dirt. Lovin, really the only time he has struggled at all was with two strikes in the second, when he allowed four straight to reach and the one run to score. This one skied right side into the outfield grass. goes Rakow, and he makes the catch for out number one.
Hey, calling off Justin Brooks, who was coming over from his position at second.
That'll bring up Aaron Ness, his first at bat, as he replaces Tommy Dutton both on the mound and at the dish.
And Logan's still looking for his first hit of the season.
This one hit really well to left field. And how about the first one of the year being a home run?
He jumped on that one. That's a way to get that first hit of the year.
And helps his own cause in the process.
Gotta love it.
Got it up into that high breeze and just let it carry beyond the left field fence.
Well, they needed that shot of adrenaline. I think the wind ate it a little bit because it's looking like blowing out. But nonetheless, I love that fact that his first hit of the season is a round tripper.
Backridge is nothing he can do but watch. And it was the first pitch that Ness saw. He just wanted to get back to the dugout.
That's right.
Mason Myrie reached on an error first time. It's ahead and they count quickly 2-0. This one slashed foul. One grounded to the left side, scooped up by Thorldson, the throw in time for out number two.
I love him. We'll see if he can get out of the inning with just the one one mistake.
Powell, an RBI walk. A little different situation here with two out, nobody on. Curveball misses wide, 0-1. Or 1-0.
One or the
other. This one hit to shallow center. Bovers waits, comes in, makes the catch, and ends the inning. Cardinals get one courtesy the long ball from their pitcher, Aaron Ness. Still, they trail 8-2 as we head to the fifth on CTA.
Properties are required to have garbage and recycling service with a licensed hauler. On collection day, place your carts 2 feet behind the curb. Collection containers should not be placed in the street. And don't forget, containers are not allowed at the curb on non-collection days. For more information on this and other city codes, log on to coonrapidsmn.gov.
When I got the opportunity to get her, there wasn't no choice. I told myself, I'm gonna take custody of my daughter. It's my baby. That's what we're supposed to do as men, take care of our home, build a foundation, you know what I'm saying? Love, our money, she's my purpose. I'm here to walk with her, hold her hand until she can walk alone. Ain't nothing like being a father in this world.
Sunstrom Field, Champlin Park had that big 6-run inning in the first. They hold an 8-2 lead as we start the fifth. Zach Sahalka, 1-for-1, RBI single and a sacrifice fly. He's driven in two. Down in the dirt. Skips to the backstop. Logan Ness has had a nice ball game since coming in relief in the third. Giving up just one hit through the first two innings of relief, and drives a home run in his first at bat.
Yeah, it's always has to feel pretty good to get one out and then get right back to the mound and see if you can prevent your opponents from getting any additional runs.
Well, and you mentioned when he came in, the one struggle he has had is with walks. And
yep.
He gives up the four-pitch walk to the leadoff man, Sahalka, here in the fifth.
The catcher, number 23, Tyler Trombley.
Bring up Tyler Trombley. He had an RBI single in the first, struck out in the second. Now with a runner at first, nobody out, takes a strike. 0-1. And the fastball high, 1-1. Zahalka, not much of a lead over at first. This one lined into left field. Solid single for Trombley's second base hit of the ball game. Two on with nobody out here as the Rebels threatening to add to their already large lead.
Yeah, they're looking to try and get back a couple of those runs that they gave up in this contest after starting out 8-0.
Shortstop Joe Tharaldson is 0-2 with a pop-up and a ground-out. And we'll see. We've seen the Rebels look to play some small ball, drop down bunts, move runners along. We'll see if Tharaldson tries to do that. He does definitely show the bunt, but pulls back to take the pitch outside, 1-0.
Yeah, if he can sacrifice his at-bat to move runners to second and third, that's exactly what they'd like to accomplish.
Up high, 2-0. Climbed the ladder for that one, but sprays it foul. Two and one. Shows bunt again and offers at it. The pitch was low. It's 2-2. Two on, nobody out here. Top of the fifth inning. And that is a called third strike.
That's
for out number one.
Yeah, big strike out there for the Cardinals.
The third baseman, number 24, Jack Harris.
Back to the top of the order. Jack Harris, another look at it. Tharaldson felt that one was inside, but punched out at the plate. Harris, an RBI or a double in his first at bat. He later scored. He also walked in that first inning. This one hit high down the right field line into foul territory. Right chasing, able to make the catch for out number two.
Yeah, nice job by Patrick just to range with it and make sure that he got the ball in foul territory. And he made sure he looked at the runner at second, wouldn't let him advance.
The second baseman, number nine.
It's a big second out.
That'll bring up Justin Brooks. Brooks 2-for-2. Single, a double, a run scored. RBI. He's also hit by a pitch. That's where he got his RBI. Off-speed in for a strike, 0-1. This one hit to center, but pretty much right at McCullough. He waits on it, makes the catch for out number three. So after a walk and a single, Ness gets three straight outs. Cardinals back at the plate after this on CTN.
Did you know Coon Rapids has a city code regulating the height of your grass? Grass and weeds must be kept under 8 inches high. Thank you for helping our city look its best. For more information on this and other city codes, log on to CoonRapidsMN.gov.
I've been driving a truck for 40 years now. If people knew what I know, lives could be saved. Like that trucks can't stop quickly. It takes my 80,000-pound truck 200 yards to come to a complete stop. So I always do my best to give a lot of cushion. It helps when other drivers realize that and do the same. Please give trucks the space we need so we can all stay safe. It's our roads. It's our safety.
Don't forget the sunscreen.
Yes.
Easy to do this deep into the spring. We've hardly had to use it, but the sun is definitely out this afternoon.
You should apply sunscreen each and every day, cloud or cloudy or sunny.
There you go. There you go.
Very important.
Good advice from.
Did you know I'm selling sunscreen now?
Well, you know, when you look at, to know how old you are, when I'll take your advice when it comes to staying healthy and looking young.
Well, thank you.
There's no doubt.
You keep me young, Mr.
I still want directions to the Fountain of Youth, but as of yet, you are keeping that information to yourself. Top of the order here for the Cardinals in the bottom of the fifth inning. A lot of work still to be done. Mark Manders, 0-for-2, has been punched out both times he's come to the plate.
Yeah, he's too good a hitter to go 0-for.
You calling it?
Yeah, I'm calling it right here.
There he is. No pressure, Mr. Manders. 2-1 pitch from Lovin down and away. Lovin just one walk so far this afternoon. But that is his second, as Manders will get on base as the leadoff runner here in the fifth.
Did I mention that he was going to walk?
Tyler Donnell also 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts. One looking, one swinging. Inside 1-0. Well, and Coon Rapids likes to be aggressive on the base paths typically, and they'll definitely try and drop down some bunts and play some small ball, but that kind of taken out of the playbook when you fall behind 6-0 in the first half of the first inning. Good pitch there from Love and evens the count 1-1. Breaking pitch drops low, 2-1.
Well, they'd like both Manders and Donnell on the base paths because both of them have some speed and both of them can steal bases, quite obviously. 1-2 on the squad.
That one was high. Donnell went up after it, fouls it out of play. It's 2-2. Manders, not much of a lead over at first. 2-2 pitch, hit well, but foul. And we'll try again. Loving a quick look over his shoulder at the runner. Curveball ties Donnell in knots. Donnell struck out for the third time. Got six strikeouts in the game for Lovin, five of the six to the top two guys in the Cardinal order. Zach White, 0 for 2, but that one off the top of his helmet.
Off the noggin.
And he will get a free base. Looks like he's okay.
Yeah. Might leave a bit of a ring in your ear, but it seems to be okay.
That'll bring up Jaden Kopp. Kopp 0 for 2. But when he grounded to third base, though, in the third inning, an errant throw allowed him to reach. And then he was later thrown out at the plate from right field, ending a threat in the third. Now he comes up with two on, one out. Been backwards on that all day. First pitch grounded up the middle, and it gets underneath the glove of Brooks. Manders will turn. He will come home and score. And the Cardinals continue to chip away at that big lead.
Now it's just one away. They'd certainly like to have the opportunity for a big inning here because the way Jordan Ness is pitching, he's pitching pretty well under control. And as you mentioned, a big hill to climb. As you're down by six, but now an opportunity. Now you're down by five.
Well, that was a potential double play ball,
yeah.
And just
yep.
A little ole by Justin Brooks. Allows the Cardinals to keep it going with two on and only one out. Zach Novak. Has one of the Cardinals' three hits on the afternoon. Lovin jumps ahead of him 0-2 quickly. Up high, 1-2.
Yeah, Lovin needs the second out here just to take a little pressure off himself.
Not a play.
And he has to be careful in this situation too, because he doesn't. He doesn't want to give Novak anything that he can push to the green. Oh, that was a pretty
curveball in for a strike. 2-2.
Oh, that's a strikeout.
Strike three.
Big second out for the Rebels here. Trying to just limit the Cardinals just the one run.
Second time he has struck out Novak, so seven strikeouts, but only against three Cardinal hitters. Patrick Wright singled and scored in the second inning. Now with two out, two on, chops this one foul in front of third. And Lovin ahead in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, great spot to be in when you want to get out of that inning, hit 0-2. She jams him inside a little.
This one down and away, skips past Trombley, both runners will advance. Still 1-2 to right. No hits in the inning, but the Cardinals have one across and have two more in scoring position. A 1-2 pitch, swung on and missed. Three strikeouts in the inning for Jack Lovin. We go to the sixth with Champlin leading Coon Rapids 8-3 on CTF.
How was school?
Music can help you express how you're feeling. When you can't find the language, find the lyrics.
At the ballpark, Champlin Park, Coon Rapids. 8-3 in favor of the Rebels. Guaranteed more errors on both sides of the ledgers than the coaches would like.
Oh, absolutely.
Three scoreless innings in relief so far for Aaron Ness, or Logan Ness. Aaron's his older brother.
Yeah.
And he's wearing number 6, who last year was Aaron Yund.
The only Aaron Yund.
This is definitely Logan.
I thought we'd see Aaron at the ballpark today.
Apparently not.
Yeah, apparently not is right.
Fastball driven down the left field line and just foul as Rockow was looking for his second extra base hit of the afternoon. Had an RBI double, two-run double in the first. And he clubbed this one good.
Yes,
but
he did.
Hooks and just lands foul. Just about 3 feet foul. Deep in the corner.
Yep.
Since the double, a couple of fly balls to center for Rockow. Fouls it off again, and that will put Ness in the driver's seat 0-2. Fastball up high, and Rockow lays off. That one right down the pipe. Rockow just looked at it. That was belt high right down Broadway. Easy call for strike 3. He's not going to argue with that call.
No, he cannot.
Third strikeout for Ness. And now Ryan Oberstar. The DH first pitch hammered down that left field line and deep, and it is foul. Had home run distance.
It did have distance, but it tailed to the foul portion of the field, but it definitely had home run distance.
He crushed it.
Yep. Just a long strike.
Oberstar.
Oh, I hit him.
Takes it off the hip. Reaches base for the third time in 4 trips. Well, it's safer than giving him that fastball again,
right?
I guess. Bring up Christian Backridge's. Backridge is 0-for-3, reached on an error and scored in the second inning. Off-speed pitch just floats in for a strike. 0-1. That froze him good. He thought it was fastball, then got way out ahead, and then just watched. Good sinking pitch
really
there.
Really nice pitch.
And Ness ahead in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, again, ahead in the count.
misses low. But he's got a couple to play with here. This one hit into short left field for a single. So two on with one out. Center fielder Toby Bovers, a bunt single and then scored in the first. Looks at a fastball high.
A good patient at the good patience at the plate.
And now down low, 2-0. Fastball in for a strike. Two and one. And now 3-1. Called strike, and it's a full count. Oh. And that is a called third strike.
Bovers thought that was a free pass, but he gets a free pass to the dugout.
The right fielder, number 7, Zach Zahalka.
It'll bring up right fielder. Another look at that. Yeah, he's got an argument.
I think he's got a point.
Looks a little wide.
Yes, it did.
But all that matters is how the guy in blue calls it. Zahalka, big swinging strike at the first offering. Zahalka, 1-for-1, had an RBI single and then scored in the first. A sacrifice fly in the second, and then walked in the fifth. But I will say this, I think the strike zone has been relatively wide all game. And as long as it's consistent. Zahalka swings under the high heat. Third strikeout in the inning. Fifth of the outing for Logan Ness. It's 8-3 as we head to the bottom of the sixth on CTN.
There! What do we do?
You may not be able to plan ahead for a ghost encounter.
Under the dining table now!
But you can plan ahead for natural disasters. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts.
Maybe it's the apocalypse.
Know your evacuation routes and decide on a safe emergency meeting location.
Here? I know. What a big Orlando.
Protecting your family is the best plan you can make. So pass the proton pack to the next generation and visit ready.gov/plan to get started.
Back at Sunstrom Field, bottom of the sixth inning, Champlin Park in 8-3 lead. Jack Lovin will give way to Jack Harris on the hill.
Now pitching for the Rebels, number 24, Jack Harris.
So Ryan Oberstar.
Third.
He had been in as the DH, so lineup should stay the same. Logan Ness leading off. First pitch that he saw this afternoon, he put over the left field fence.
Yeah, that was a good at bat.
Harris comes out dealing strikes, couple of fastballs, gets him ahead in the count, 0-2. And then comes in with the curveball and drops it right in. No argument from Ness as he heads back to the dugout.
Yeah, quick at bat, as quick as that that first at bat was, just about as quick for the second.
It's a nice looking pitch, good break. Looked like it was coming inside to the right-handed hitter, and you saw him kind of shade away from it and then dropped right in. Mason Myrie, 0-for-2, reached on an error back in the second inning. Fouls it to the backstop, 1-1. Fastball misses down and away. In all, a pretty solid outing for Jack Lovin. 8 strikeouts. Couple of walks. Gave up 3 runs. Both teams came into the game at 5-8 on the season. There's that curveball again, and you saw that right-handed batter duck away, looking like it was coming in on him and coming in high, and it dropped right in. And really, Myrie was headed back to the dugout before the umpire even called it a strike. There you see it.
Yep.
Looked like he was going to hit him in the head, and he just turned and went, oh.
Caught that corner.
Did that really just happen? That's a nice-looking pitch.
Yeah, really nice.
And now number 9 hitter Adam Powell. Got an RBI on the walk with the bases loaded back in the second inning. But back-to-back strikeouts to start the relief outing for Jack Harris. He's got plenty of cushion with a 5-run lead. Fastball in for a strike.
Yeah, and he's doing a good job mixing his pitches a little bit. And as you said, that pitch, that change in the inside portion of the plate has really fooled a couple of the Cardinals.
Fastball gets it to 2-2. Yeah, I would watch for that curveball right here.
Yep. Yeah, absolutely.
And if I'm Trombley, I'm definitely calling the curveball because it has been a money pitch with 2 strikes. He stays on the gas. He gets called 3rd strike. 3 straight punch outs for Jack Harris. And we go to the 7th inning. Champlin Park trying to close out the win with an 8-3 lead.
Any vehicles left outside on your property must be in operable condition and parked on an improved surface with current registration displayed. And repairing or dismantling vehicles outside is a violation of city code. For more information on this and other city codes, log on to coonrapidsmn.gov.
least it's a nice day to be at the ballpark.
Beautiful day.
Cardinals fans have not had a whole lot to cheer about. Rebels jump to a 6-0 lead in the top of the first inning and had an 8-0 lead after an inning and a half. Cardinals have chipped away a little bit, but still a big 8-3 lead for the Rebels. Tyler Trombley leading things off here in the seventh. It's 2-for-3 this afternoon with an RBI. This one hit right back up the middle in a leadoff single.
Well, Rebels starting off here early, putting pressure on the Cardinals again with that leadoff single.
Well, so far, Aaron Ness has done a nice job in relief, 4 scoreless innings.
Yep.
It's only the second time in his 5 innings that he has allowed the leadoff man on board. Looks like we have a courtesy runner for the catcher, Trombley. And shortstop, Joe Thoroldson at the plate. He's 0-for-3.
That's Joe Cummings over at first base as the courteous runner.
Courteous?
Yeah, courteous and courtesy.
I'm not sure how courteous he'll be, but we'll see. This one hit through the hole on the left side, back-to-back singles to start the seventh for Champlin Park.
Well, that's the way the Rebels wanted to start if they wanted to up this lead.
Back to the top of the order. Doubled and scored in the first. Since then, a walk and a couple of outs. Fastball in for a strike, evens the count.
Well, that was the 11th base hit of the afternoon for the Rebels. And the Cardinals certainly cannot afford to give up any more runs here if they want to try and get a big comeback.
Yeah, the 5 runs is a big enough challenge, especially since Harris came in and struck out the side. They will have the top of the order in the bottom of the seventh. That one got through the legs on Ness, and Manders couldn't control it either. Everybody safe, bases loaded, nobody out. Call that E6. We'll have a pinch runner at first.
Michael Prosch.
And I can't say for sure, but he's not the prototypical runner you put on for speed.
Long strides.
He's a big kid over
long
there.
Long strides. Takes him 3 steps to get down to second base.
There is that. Justin Brooks is the batter with bases loaded, nobody out.
Kind of reminds me of Josh Udvig in that way. No, Josh would. Josh takes more like 3 minutes to get down to second base.
So it's skied back and out of play. Brooks 2-for-3 this afternoon with a single, a double, also hit by a pitch with the bases loaded, so he has an RBI. Last at bat, a fly ball to center field, hit pretty much right at Colin McCullough. This one hit well again to center. McCullough ranges to his right, makes the catch, tagging and coming home from third is Cummings. So a sacrifice fly makes it a 9-3 lead.
Yeah, that makes that deficit, as you talked about, even more difficult. Now trailing by 6.
That'll bring up first baseman Andrew Rockow. Rockow 1-for-4 with a two-run double back in the first inning. That started the scoring. Did a couple pretty well out to center field.
Is this a gamer?
Rockow hits it hard through the right side of the infield. Thoroldson turns, comes home. He will score from second. RBI single for Rockow makes it 10-3.
Yeah, they didn't hesitate to send him at all. Still just one away.
It'll bring up Ryan Oberstar, now playing at third base for the Rebels. Rockow with his second hit, third RBI of the ball game. Fastball in for a strike, 0-1. Oberstar hit by a pitch last time up. This one skied behind third in foul territory. White drifting to his right, able to make the catch. Route number two.
All important second out of the inning. Got underneath that pitch. A good play by White to get over there, make sure he stayed with it.
Bring up Christian Backridges. 1-for-4. First pitch, foul out of play. This one hit to center. McCullough coming in. He'll make the catch and end the inning. But two more on the board for Champlin Park. They lead 10-3 as we head to the third, or head to the bottom of the seventh on CTF. Blue skies overhead following a stormy evening last night at a tornado touchdown here in Coon Rapids.
I want to try and forget last night.
Well, and more severe.
I have no power. I've had no power since 8 yesterday.
More severe storms could possibly be coming in later tonight.
Well, they say after 10 o'clock.
Top of the order for the Cardinals here in the bottom of the seventh. They need 7 to tie, 8 to win. Mark Manders walked and scored in the fifth inning. So far, Jack Harris has pretty much been dealing.
He has.
Since taking over in the sixth, struck out the side in his first inning of relief. Staying on the gas, but missing high, 2-1. Takes a little something off of it to find the zone. Evens the count, 2-2. Manders punched out twice by the starter, Jack Lovin, before earning that walk. Curveball, and he's punched out for the third time tonight.
That was pretty.
Yeah, he got punch outs on all three men he faced in the sixth inning, and now so four in a row that he's punched out. Three of those four strikeouts have been on curveballs where it is just frozen right-handed batters. Manders the first one not to duck away, thinking the pitch was coming in at him. Colin McCullough will get an at bat here. Tyler Donnell had been hitting in this spot for him and had struck out three times. Fastball misses high. And right in there to even it up. 1-1.
Yeah, Harris trying to finish up what Jack Lovin started.
Misses out the outside edge. Swung on and missed. It's 2-2.
Nice pitch from Harris there to even it up.
One lot of strikeouts for the Cardinals this afternoon.
Yeah, way too many.
And if he can get the strikeout here, that would be eight strikeouts, which he does. Eight strikeouts in your top two batting spots. That's not how you draw it up.
That makes it difficult. Cards down there to last at bat. Yep, nice pitch.
That's the 14th strikeout for Champlin Park pitchers. Zach White, 0 for on the day. A fly out, a ground out. Was hit by pitch his last time up. Need the mega rally here. Mega super duper sized rally. Curveball, unfortunately, he got the bat down because that might have hit the bat behind his head.
Ooh, did not miss by much.
But outside, yeah. And it's 2-2. Fouled back, and he'll stay alive at 2-2. This one hammered down the line, but will hook foul. And we'll try again.
Yeah, Harris shook off Trombley twice before he delivered that pitch.
Hit into center and will fall in front of Bovers. So a two-out single will keep the Cardinals alive here in the bottom of the seventh.
Yeah, keeping hope alive in the bottom of the seventh, trailing by seven. Just the fourth hit of the afternoon for Coon Rapids. Rebels sit at a dozen.
Jaden Kopp takes an off-speed pitch for a strike, 0-1. He's reached on an error twice. Fouled back, 0-2. Well, at the very least, White's two-out single kept Harris's relief stint from being perfect. Swung
That's
on
it.
And missed. Pretty impressive outing for Jack Harris coming in, striking out six, giving up just the one hit in relief. But it all comes down to that top half of the first inning.
Oh, yeah.
When they scored six runs.
You can't do that. You can't fall behind. You can't fall behind 8-0, and it makes it very difficult to come back.
So Coon Rapids will drop to 5-9 on the season, and the Rebels will move ahead of them in the conference standings. Just a couple of weeks left, and as we always talk about, what you do in the regular season only matters so much. Everybody makes the playoffs, and that's when it really matters. We have the playoffs on the upcoming schedule. We're going to see the softball team night game tomorrow night against St. Louis Park Orioles. See the baseball team again next week against Maple Grove. Then it's playoff time, and we'll follow the Cardinals as far as they go. But that's going to do it for this edition of CTN Sports. Again, the final score, Champlin Park 10, Coon Rapids 3. I want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. And the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young. Say goodnight.